I call on Deputy Micheál Martin, August 3, Bowman Jogget.
Thank you, that's Kion Corlin. Taoiseach, last Friday I visited the Capuchin Day Centre and met with Brother Kevin Crowley and his team there. Their work is truly heroic, the personification of true Christian values, their simple objective being to relieve the hardship endured by homeless people. But their work gives crucial insights, Taoiseach, into the failure of the various housing strategies and interventions to date to resolve the crisis. They're at the coalface, Taoiseach, and they see the daily realities of this failure in the number of people turning up for breakfast, for lunch, for food parcels, and in particular, the extraordinary number of children in emergency accommodation who also attend this particular centre. And their story at the coalface is one of a scandal becoming worse, and particularly for the children. Some years back, they were told the emergency accommodation crisis for children would be solved. Just to give you an insight, Taoiseach, in 2013, there were 4,747 children attending for lunch. In 2016, there was 8,353. It's a 76% increase. A shocking indictment. They're extremely worried in particular about the overall well-being of these children who are forced to attend the centre and the very debilitating and damaging impact that emergency accommodation environment is having on their development. It's heartrending, Taoiseach, and the state is failing these children right now. Total presentations at the centre, Taoiseach, are close to 400,000 a year in availing of the various services. The costs are about 3.5 million. The state's contribution, Taoiseach, 450,000. Embarrassing relative to the scale of the crisis and the response of this centre to it. Ministers have visited the centre. You have visited the centre, Taoiseach. And yet, they had a social worker in 2012 who retired. That social worker has never been replaced. Minister Zappone has acknowledged the urgent need for a child welfare officer, particularly on child protection issues. But nothing has happened. And there's a number of other demands and requests that they have made. But the key point, Taoiseach, is this, that the disconnect between the reality at the coalface, as evidenced by the daily work at this centre, and the official rhetoric about strategies and interventions is enormous. The housing policies are not impacting on this daily reality. It's getting worse, Taoiseach. We're not building enough council houses. That's a fact. There's some ideological opposition to it across the system. It's appalling. And houses are not being built fast enough. And the accommodation crisis, the emergency accommodation crisis, is getting worse for children, which should be our overall priority. So, Taoiseach, I want you to recognise and acknowledge this reality, and also to work with the centre to attend to their immediate needs in terms of recognising the reality of the emergency crisis with children and working to provide the officers they require and the assistance that the children require in particular. Because this reality isn't going anywhere soon. That's my point. And would you acknowledge that the interventions to date have not made any dent on these appalling, on this appalling indictment of state policy?
Thanks. Well, this is part of the challenge that that we face as a society and as a government in delivering to provide services for people in various categories who have real problems here. I've been down to Brother Kevin myself on a number of occasions, and he's an extraordinary man. An extraordinary man, has been doing this for years. And obviously the numbers who turn up at his centre speak for themselves. But it's not all without inactivity, put it that way. The government have allocated serious resources for tackling homelessness in the budget for this year. €100 million are actually being spent on homeless services this year. €100 million. Not an insignificant figure. And in addition, the overall housing budget for this year is 1,300 million, 1.3 billion. Now, you and I have discussed this before, and the issue is how fast can you build houses that are necessary? The Minister set out targets for not having people in emergency accommodation, set out targets for providing accommodation for homeless or for rough sleepers in hostels in various locations in Dublin, some of which are extraordinarily successful. In last year, in 2016, 3,052 households exited homelessness, which is the highest level ever, and the ambition is very high this year. You talk about building houses. Yes, the work is underway at the moment on advancing 650 rapid-build homes in 2017, another 500 units in 2018. O'Devany Gardens is up the road from the Brother Kevin Centre, which has lain there for years and which is now underway. You have places like George's Place, Thunleary, 12 homes, St Aidan's, Brookfield, 71 homes, Papentry, Ballymun, 22, Cherry Orchard, Ballyframer, 24, and so on. So work is and construction is actually underway in quite a lot of places. I agree that it's not by any means perfect, and I do agree that there are always gaps in the level of services that are provided. But these are issues that are being addressed on a constant basis, Deputy Martin, as you're well aware. Clearly, the Department of Housing, with a special unit therein, which meets on a very regular basis and has provided incentives and opportunities and shortcuts for local authorities so that social housing can be built, for private enterprise to be able to come in and build houses on public property, for local authorities to provide houses. The development of the HAP scheme has made an important contribution, and indeed the putting of the home and services around those who have particular difficulties. The Dublin Region Homeless Executive confirmed a minimum of 142 people on their last count at the end of the year. Obviously, developments have taken place for the provision of beds in what are very good hostels, and I've looked at a number of those myself. Brother Kevin does an extraordinary job. And obviously, it's part of the enormous range of challenges that the government is trying to meet here. So until you have your engine that can drive your economy to provide these services, be it chiropody or dental or whatever, down in those centres, you may shake your head. It's not as perfect as one would wish. But these are matters that are receiving real priority from not just the HSE, but from the different agencies, to try to deal in the best way possible, in the most effective way possible, for many of these people. And part of that is putting on the table 100 million for services and 1.3 billion this year for housing for the homeless, social housing and so on.
I would ask all to try and adhere to the time. Deputy Micheál Martin,
see, Taoiseach,
1 minute.
That response, 100 million, it's meaningless. I mean, first of all, emergency. The hotel money is an appalling waste of money. An appalling waste of money. I mean, the captioning centre gets 450,000. And you talk about 100 million for children in emergency accommodation. And I give you the figures again, Taoiseach. In 2013, 4,747 children attended for meals at that centre. At the end of last year, 8,353 attendances for meals. That says it all, Taoiseach. And there is that terrible disconnect between the official rhetoric and the reality. And the census figures from the CSO, Taoiseach, give the truth as well. 2% of all houses and apartments occupied nationwide at the moment are new. 2%, built between 2011 and last year. 11,572 new houses were built in Dublin during that time, between 2011 and last year. And you know the big difference between the CSO's figures and the Department of Environment's figures in terms of actual new builds. So, in no way, Taoiseach, is the response commensurate with the scale of the crisis. And then one lesson I took away from the Capuchin Centre, what they wanted to bring across to Leinster House, was the enormous impact on the children in terms of the stigma of homelessness, the lack of any stable, permanent anchor in their lives, the psychological impact, and no officers appointed. The very least you should do, Taoiseach, is recognise the reality of this for the children and at least give additional supports to the centre to cope with the reality. And I would ask that the government ministers would do that in terms of the officers that they require and the additional supports that they require.
1 minute, Taoiseach.
Children who have challenges and particular difficulties from different parts of the country, every local authority has at its disposal finance and services to provide in the best way possible for those children. And there are some with very particular difficulties, as you are well aware. But government have made the decision to put 5.3 billion to deliver social housing between here and 2021. Now, you say there's a disconnect between that figure and the reality of what's happening on the ground. Well, Minister for Housing and the Minister of State for Housing have been to every single local authority and said, there's your money, show me your sites, build your houses, here are the incentives. Years ago, local authorities were very active in building houses, and the range now between approved housing facilities and local authorities, the money's on the table, Deputy Martin. The housing assistance payment this year will accommodate 15,000 households, 15,000 to keep them in their homes. Last year, nearly 18,500 housing supports were provided from a housing budget provision of 935 million, which was spent in full for that very purpose, to keep people in their homes. And that included nearly 5,300 homes that were built, homes that were purchased, and 12,000 housing HAP tenancies. So in pillar three of the Minister's programme, it's to build 25,000 units per annum on average by 2021. You're well aware now of the scale of the challenge here in having to build the houses that resulted, which weren't built following the total collapse of the construction sector a number of years ago.
Before I call on Deputy MacDonald, I want to, on my own behalf and behalf of the members of the Dáil, to offer a Céad Míle Fáilte to Mr. Joe Fitzpatrick, Member of the Scottish Parliament and Minister for Parliamentary Business. I hope that your visit will be enjoyable, successful, and to our mutual benefit. Fáilte.